I never forget to mention how awful men treat women nowadays, but how about women treating men like shit? We never talk about how men are used, abused, and treated poorly. There is a percentage of women nowadays that are just the worst.
How dare you?
Nowadays, you give a woman a finger, she takes the entire hand.
Yes, that is very true.
And before you decide on attacking me through these comments section, please just understand that I'm not talking about all women. Whatever you give her is never enough.
Subscribe
And just
now.
like women, it's always the good men that get screwed over. 4 out of 5 women do not respect their man when he chooses to provide for her and care for her. 3 out of 5 women begin to lose respect for their man once he begins to do everything for her.
Women.
Dear men, once you begin to feel your woman is losing interest, respect, or love toward you, that's when you start to back off. Dear men, once you begin to feel that you're doing too much for your woman, you probably are. Once you begin to feel your woman is being unappreciative, do less. The moment you begin to feel that your woman does not care is the moment she doesn't. Now, don't get me wrong, we're all human and we all make mistakes and we all say stupid things. But that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about being disrespected once you respect your woman, about being treated poorly when you provide for your woman, about being treated like you are nothing when you treat your woman like she is everything to you. And it's so sad because these good men then turn either revengeful or don't put themselves out there anymore, even though there's good women that are caring, loving, loyal, and appreciative out there.
Sensational.
Protect feminism or low gas prices?
I guess low gas prices, because ever since the feminist movement, it's been a lot harder for me to find a guy to pay my bills.
What do you mean by that?
And all of a sudden I have to work and I have to do all these things, and I honestly don't want to work. I would rather stay in the kitchen.
Whoa, here I come.
Oh, mind you, I need some cooking classes, but I think I could take a couple cooking classes and make somebody really happy.
It's funny because it's true.
Okay, that was actually like so sweet at the end. That seemed very genuine. I thought the first part of like, I just want a guy to pay my bills, like that's a, yeah, but also, I mean, valid point. There was a time when women did not have to work. I mean, they could if they wanted to, but these days, like somebody commented and said, yeah, let's go back to a world where the normal couple can live off of one income. Blame the government and their taxes. That is the reason why we cannot. Somebody else said, I'm actually sad the comments are saying this is the woman they want. Wow. Men want a woman who will cook for them and, you know, turn their house into a home. That is shocking.
How dare you?
That's not ridiculous. That's not ridiculous to say.
If women want men to be themselves, why should men acquire the skill of game?
We don't want you to be yourself.
Yes, that is very true.
So we should lie to you.
Be the man I want, but I'm not in the final.
So we should play a character.
Away.
Wouldn't that bring problems in a relationship? Later stage.
Why are you changing? Be that person I wanted you to be. Why are you changing?
Why can't I be myself?
I don't like you.
Women.
It was a mistake. I lived quite a feminist lifestyle for quite some time.
What do you mean you lived a feminist lifestyle?
I'm independent financially and all of those things, and I kind of pursued my career for a really long time. I pursued my academics for a really long time. I really appreciate all of that. I think as you get older, you realize how unfulfilling all of those things are, and when you're sold that dream for a really long time, you're so convinced that that can't wait, and you're so convinced that marriage, kids, and becoming all of those things that are more traditional can wait, when really, biologically, it's the other way around. So for me, I would say it was a good mistake.
I was just saying it to my sister the other day. I wish I got married at around 18, 19, 20. By now, my child would have been a teenager. Yeah. You know, it just would have been a lot easier. I've got a child that's just out of the toddler phase, and I'm knackered.
Oh my God, she's so annoying.
The report shows that by 2030, 45% of working women
ages 25 to 45, by 2030 will be non-married, no kids, single. Yeah. Okay. So you might say, well, what's wrong with that? Okay. If you think that you're going to be 45 years old, no kids, not married, and that you're going to genuinely be fulfilled in life because you made money, best of luck to you, honey.
How dare you?
So a woman called me. She said, I'm 50 years old. I have 3 degrees. I'm a very successful entrepreneur, CEO. And I want you to know, Dennis, I deeply regret that I followed the feminist advice at college. Because when I come home after a successful day at work to an empty home, no husband, no children, no family, it's not good.
You could not live with your own failure. Where did that bring you? Back to me.
Men and women were not the same. And when we try to compete with each other, trying to outdo each other with what the other person was naturally designed to do, we lose sight on what makes us great. And when we ignore our own talents, abilities, and qualities, now we don't have qualities to bring to the table. We ain't supposed to compete with each other. We're supposed to complement each other. Equal in value, different in function.
What does that mean?
To take something in.
Okay, excellent. To absorb. Anyone?
Everywhere, all the time.
So what is ubiquitous assimilation?
Always absorbing everything, everywhere, all the time.
Well done, George. How are you to imagine anything if the images are always provided for you? Who here read 1984 last year? Good. Anyone? Meredith?
Having 2 opposing beliefs at once and believing that both are true.
Excellent, Meredith. To deliberately believe in lies while knowing they're false. Examples of this in everyday life. Oh, I need to be pretty to be happy. I need surgery to be pretty. I need to be thin, famous, fashionable. This is a marketing holocaust. 24 hours a day for the rest of our lives. The powers that be are hard at work, dumbing us to death. So, to defend ourselves and fight against assimilating this dullness into our thought processes, we must learn to read, to stimulate our own imaginations, to cultivate our own consciousness, our own belief systems. We all need these skills to defend, to preserve our own minds.